What's happening, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Aha, and we're going back to the 2022 album True North, and we're up to the tune Between the Halo and the Horn. It seems pretty straightforward. It seems like a religiously framed exploration of morality, maybe with the implication being that that's where the majority of humanity resides. You know, maybe there's some exceptions, you know, people who are very saintly and constantly selfless and struggling for others and never asking for anything for themselves and constantly trying to improve the lives of other people and so on, whereas on the other end there might be some people who genuinely, from the moment they wake to the moment they go to sleep, are trying to exploit and deceive and take advantage of, and generally to, you know, do all the worst possibilities that humans may be capable of. I think the majority of humanity is somewhere in between. Maybe some people closer to one end, maybe some people closer to the other end. But yeah, I think most of humanity resides between the halo and the horn. So when I see that phrase, it feels like an exploration or discussion of morality or of, you know, ethical character on some level. And perhaps, you know, it won't be so broad as that, you know, trying to assess where all of humanity resides on a moral scale. But it might be the way in which a given situation feels like you have to make a choice, one that may be more personally helpful or benefiting, but one which perhaps could be seen as unethical, and then something that is not ideal from your own perspective, but might be the right thing to do, and you might feel caught between the halo and the horn. And indeed, the very, you know, visual reference often used in, you know, cartoons and even more serious fiction, of a, you know, angel sitting on one shoulder and a devil sitting on another, and both of them vying for the control of the decision-making agency of a person. I think that's a pretty common trope. So it feels like something along those lines. Now, obviously, this could have nothing to do with what the song is about, but when I looked at it, this one felt less cryptic than some of their other titles. So let's find out. This is Aha. The tune is Between the Halo and the Horn, and it's from the 2022 album True North.
Ask you what's happening. And it's like my brain is like, is it an acoustic? like they were tapping into some of the folksier, guitar-driven tunes that, you know, as they transitioned in sound through the 90s into the early 2000s, it felt like, you know, there was some of that flavor in this track, obviously more than 20 years later, but yeah, it felt less like their 80s stuff, a bit more like some of the 90s stuff, I guess is what I'm saying. And yeah, I didn't catch all the lines. I caught a number of them, and like I said, it seemed like maybe it was talking about, you know, again, rose and thorn is, you know, you can't extract one from the other. So you get the beauty, the fragrance of the rose, but you also get the thorn, the, you know, sort of the thing that protects it in nature, but also the thing which, you know, can cut your hand or is not as pleasant as the rest of the rose. But again, you can't have the flower of the rose without the thorn. So it felt like maybe it was saying that, like, in everyone, there's a capacity for the halo and the horn. So we're all sort of between the halo and the horn. But again, there were some other lines where, and I think the one that I thought of, or that I noticed most specifically, is the idea of like basking in the afterglow, but then get on with the show. And, you know, get on with the show feels like we're forward-looking, and it's about what's gonna happen or what we are doing now, whereas the afterglow is, you know, really savoring in the experience that you've had and, you know, maybe not wanting to go to sleep because you don't want to let that feeling of what you've just been through dissipate. So yeah, there were a couple moments where it felt like the phrases being used were dichotomous or at odds with each other, so I don't know if that was part of the theme. But either way, a really cool tune. Yeah, again, looking forward to the rest of this album. I'm, again, probably going to concentrate on this almost exclusively. Maybe we'll go back and do one or two of the live tracks from some of the live albums I'm still going through. But yeah, once we finish this, I'll circle back and finish off ending on a high note. We'll go back and hit the one or two tracks on How Can I Sleep With Your Voice in My Head. And again, there's all sorts of stuff beyond that. Obviously, the Unplugged album, I haven't really gone through that much. But again, people, given what people were saying, I will focus on True North here and then go through Unplugged, ending on a high note, and any of the official live stuff that I haven't finished. At which point, we can then start going through some of the bootleg stuff, any of the rarities or B-sides still remaining. And again, at some point, I'd like to go through a second look series where I go back to some of these tracks, now having heard them many more times and thought about them and enjoyed them perhaps on a more knowledgeable level with the group overall. And I think that would be enjoyable. So hopefully some of you up for that. Again, next 3-4 weeks, it will be a little lighter than normal, maybe only, you know, an aha every 2 to 3 days. Like in some cases, I might not be able to do any reactions, so that might make it 3 to 4 days. But I assure you, through all this, the aha reactions will continue even this month, and then after that, back to a more regular schedule. And indeed, a number of people already reached out and said, hey, you know, we're willing to be patient, so wanted to say a big thank you to all of you. I really appreciate the aha family. And yeah, bottom line, let me know what you think of this track. Looking forward to the next one. I will see you next time. Peace.